And now, redemption time with Nnamdi the lecturer.
Greetings, I am Nnamdi and welcome to Redemption Time. I am a student of Africana Studies, and as a student of Africana Studies, I have come to realize how important it is for those of us who are of African ancestry to tell our story. It is important for us to tell that half of history that was hidden from us as Caribbean people, as African people, as the many peoples of the earth. My topic is Claude McKay, a Caribbean poet of the Harlem Renaissance. The Harlem Renaissance was a period in the history of Harlem, New York, USA, that lasted from about 1919 to 1940. It was a time of entertainment and poetic protest, when people of African ancestry in America were beginning to redefine themselves. Claude McKay, one of the inaugurating poets of the Harlem Renaissance, a great literary liberator, a poet for social change and justice, born September 15, 1889, was raised in the parish of Clarendon, Jamaica, West Indies. He penned one of that period's most profound and inspirational poems, a sonnet entitled, If We Must Die. It goes like this. If we must die, let it not be like hogs, hunted and penned in an inglorious spot, while round us bark the mad and hungry dogs, making their mock at our cursed lot. If we must die, oh, let us nobly die, so that our precious blood may not be shed in vain. Then even the monsters we defy shall be constrained to honor us, though dead. O kinsmen, we must face the common foe. Though far outnumbered, let us show us brave. And for their thousand blows, deal one death blow. What though before us lies the open grave? Like men, we'll face the murderous, cowardly pack, pressed to the wall, dying, but fighting back. Now, this poem, If We Must Die, by Claude McKay, a Jamaican, a Caribbean, a son of Africa, was a poem that was recited in a speech given by the Prime Minister of England, Winston Churchill, during World War II. And so it is that we, as people of African ancestry, should draw our inspiration from this and the many other positive poems, essays, and books that shed light on the greatest knowledge of all, the true knowledge of self, our African self. And we too must keep up the struggle to regain that true understanding, even if we must die. If you wish to know more about Claude McKay and many other writers of African ancestry, read the Norton Anthology, African American Literature, edited by Henry Louis Gates and Nellie Y. McKay. Well, as I like to say, regardless of your color, class, or race, the understanding and recognition of African history in its true context is about the understanding of the contribution of the descendants of Africa to the culture of the world. It's about understanding the race to which you belong, the human race. It is one more tool used to chip away at the wall of misunderstanding. I am Nnamdi. Until next time, redemption time. Peace.
I would never give the power to a boy.